A private Melbourne girls' school has been forced to defend preventing a same-sex student couple attending a Year 11 dinner. The furor has led to the two 16-year-olds deciding to leave the school at the end of the year.
Hannah Williams and Savannah Soupski have been dating for around 8 months, their young relationship in the spotlight after Hannah, in Year 11, couldn't take her Year 10 girlfriend to a school dinner dance.
I was pretty upset because I just didn't see how that was fair because everyone else got to bring their chosen partner and just because my chosen partner was a female.
I've never really been in a situation where I was told that I couldn't go to something because of one of the choices that I had made, so it made me really angry.
When Tyler Clemente moved into his Rutgers University dorm this fall, I'm sure he wanted what every freshman wants, to make friends, get good grades, fit in. He was a shy kid by all accounts and a talented violinist, but his new home soon turned treacherous when Tyler's roommate and another student allegedly used a webcam to broadcast him hooking up with another male student. 3 days later, he killed himself. If Tyler were gay, studies suggest he was probably harassed before and he was 4 times more likely than a straight student to commit suicide.
Look, you only have to turn on your TV set at 6:30 or at 7 o'clock and have a look at the most popular soap operas overseas, Australian soap operas overseas, Home and Away and Neighbours. Look at the representative view of Australia we are giving to people in England and Europe and other associated countries. It's one of a predominantly blonde, surfy, blue-eyed, Anglo-Saxon background community, and that is wrong.
But why has it been so hard? Why has it been so difficult to crack after now nearly 3 generations of post-war migration? Why is it so hard to get into this?
Because the people, I believe, who have the power in this country in terms of television, the owners of the television stations, the owners of the media, are predominantly Anglo-Saxon. And I don't believe we'll see a change until more people from non-Anglo-Saxon backgrounds begin to find themselves in those professional positions, positions of management, people who are in control of the media. Because they are the only people who can understand the discrimination that has been faced by millions of people in this country.